I am a monk from Creeland Abbey in Lincolnshire. We recorded the history of Britain and spoke to soldiers who were travelling home from the Battle of Bosworth Hill. This is what they told us about the events that occurred that day. Richard III had a vast number of warriors ready to fight on his side. It was said that it was the largest army ever put together in England. On the Sunday before the Feast of Bartholomew the Apostle, a religious festival held on the 24th of August, Richard III set off from Leicester with his lords, knights and huge army. His scouts told him where the enemy were likely to camp, so he set up camp around 8 miles outside of Leicester. The enemy were led by Henry Tudor, the Earl of Richmond, who they called their king. King Richard III woke the following morning, having had a restless night troubled by nightmares filled with demons. He said no matter which side won the day's battle, it would lead to the destruction of the Kingdom of England. He warned that if he was victorious, he would crush all supporters of the enemy, and that they would do the same if they won. Meanwhile, Henry Tudor's army were advancing towards the royal army. A fierce battle began, and Henry Tudor and his knights headed straight for King Richard III. The battle continued, and Richard III was pierced by a number of deadly wounds and bravely died on the battlefield. Many of Richard III's lords and knights fled when they knew that they had been defeated. Richard III's body was found and dragged by horse back to Leicester. Henry Tudor also headed to Leicester wearing Richard III's crown. The knights and lords loyal to Richard III that had been captured were executed. Henry Tudor was now crowned King Henry VII, ending the War of the Roses and becoming the first of the Tudor monarchs.